the technology likely to have the greatest impact on the next few decades has arrived. And it's not social media, it's not big data, it's not robotics, it's not even AI. And you'll be surprised to learn that it's the underlying technology of digital currencies like Bitcoin. It's called the blockchain. Blockchain. Now, it's not the most sonorous word in the world, but I believe that this is now the next generation of the internet, and that it holds vast promise for every business, every society, and for all of you individually. You know, for the past few decades, we've had the internet of information. And when I send you an email or a PowerPoint file or something, I'm actually not sending you the original, I'm sending you a copy. And that's great. This is democratized information. But when it comes to assets, things like money, financial assets like stocks and bonds, loyalty points, intellectual property, music, art, a vote, carbon credit, and other assets, sending you a copy is a really bad idea. If I send you $100, it's really important that I don't still have money and that I can't send it to you. So this has been called the double spend problem by cryptographers for a long time. So today, we rely entirely on big intermediaries, middlemen like banks, government, big social media companies, credit card companies, and so on, to establish trust in our economy. And these intermediaries perform all the business and transaction logic of every kind of commerce, from authentication, identification of people, through to clearing, settling, and record keeping. And overall, they do a pretty good job, but there are growing problems. To begin, they're centralized. That means that they can be hacked, and increasingly are. And JP Morgan, US federal government, LinkedIn, Home Depot, and others found that out the hard way. They exclude billions of people from the global economy. For example, people who don't have enough money to have a bank account. They slow things down. It can take a second for an email to go around the world, but it can take days or weeks for money to move through the banking system across the city. And they take a big piece of the action. 10 to 20% just to send money to another country. They capture our data, and that means that we can't monetize it or use it to better manage our lives. And our privacy is being undermined. And the biggest problem is that overall, they've appropriated the largesse of the digital age asymmetrically. And we have wealth creation, but we have growing social inequality.